All kids out of the pool for Adult Swim. All kids out.
Hey guys, how are you?
Hi.
I was driving by, saw the lights on, so I figured I'd stop in. Brendan, how are you?
Not bad. How are you?
Good practice today.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Good coaching.
Thank you. Paul, I'm starting to visit the kids at night now more.
Hey, coach, you parked on the lawn. Do you realize that?
I thought that was a driveway.
No, that's the lawn.
Oh. Actually, the real reason I came, Paula, was I gotta ask you a favor. My sister's coming into town, right? Friday night? It's just a layover. She's at the airport. So I would appreciate it if you come to the airport with me to say hi to her while she's waiting for her connecting flight.
I don't think I know your sister, John.
No, well, that doesn't matter, Paul. You don't have to know her to say hi to her.
But why would I go with you to the airport and say hi to your sister who I've never known?
Well, all the other moms said no. You know, so this is kind of a last-ditch effort before I have to hire an escort.
You need an escort?
I wanted you to pretend you were my fiancé,
you know,
so
John,
she wouldn't worry.
You know, John, I would, if we weren't going to the movies, I would...
No, we're not going to the movies.
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing, Paula. My sister's a lot different than me, all right? I'm freewheeling. You know, I'm in for a good time. My sister's a little more conservative. She's very religious. So she worries about me a lot because I don't live like her. You know, I live a little loose. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's good for me because I like loose. All right?
Yeah.
We go around once, Paula.
Okay.
On this crazy planet.
Well, I'm sorry I can't help you out, John.
Paula, listen. It's only 2 hours, right? We'll go out to the airport. I'll introduce you to my sister. I'll say, Donna. That's my sister's name. I'll say, Donna, this is my fiance, Paula.
Wait. You're what?
My fiance. That's what I was thinking. You would be my fiance.
You want to introduce me as your fiance?
Yeah. Yeah. Then my sister will be very proud of me. I met somebody.
So this is a ruse.
It's a what?
A ruse.
What's a ruse?
It's a ruse.
Oh, it's a ruse.
It's a ruse.
What's wrong with you? It's a ruse. Even I know that.
She meant ruse.
Brendan knew it.
You know it's late, John.
Paula.
I'm not taking part in your charade, okay?
Oh, come on, Mom. Look.
Brendan.
Wait a minute. Paula, am I smarter than you? I knew that word.
I'm sleep deprived now, all right? I'm sleep deprived.
I'm just saying, this has never happened to me before.
This is the first time he's been smart.
Okay,
Paula, because Brendan is smart.
He is smart, yeah.
It's just weird how it happens. Sometimes dumb people have smart kids.
I'll just,
Paula, come with me to the airport.
You know...
You can bring Brendan.
Yeah.
We're dating, and I'm like his father,
Brendan,
and he loves me.
Yeah.
This is getting out of hand.
Paula, this is good.
Yeah.
Brendan, hop on.
All right.
Look at this, Paula. Now, Paula, get over here. Let me put my arm around you. Now, look in the mirror.
No.
Somebody take a picture, because this is the happiest family I've ever seen.
We got some nasty weather heading our way. You might want to exercise a little caution over the next couple of days.
And I hate that guy.
This is your goofy weather, man.
I like that part, though.
Hey, Coach, while I'm up here, let's do the You're the Dummy thing.
All right.
Ready?
Yep.
You're the Dummy.
No, you're the Dummy.
No, you're the Dummy.
You're the Dummy.
No, you're the Dummy.
I said you're the Dummy.
You're the Dummy.
No, you're actually the Dummy.
No, you really, really, really are the Dummy.
All right, I'm the... Wait a minute.
Good night.
Mr. Peelberger,
Is
it true that this movie's the first installment of what will be a 6-part trilogy?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Huh. Mr. Peelberger, did you know you were going to make movie history?
You know, that's a good question. Nobody really ever knows if they're going to make movie history, but I wanted to make sure that I did. So that's why I changed the name of this movie, which was originally entitled Planet Battles, to Movie History. So when anybody asked me what I was working on, I would say, I'm making movie history.
And you did.
And I did.
You made a film called Movie History.
Well, let's just say I made movie history. Say it. Say it.
You're making movie history.
I'm making movie history.
So, Stan, what was it like working on movie history with an all-star cast and an all-star director?
It was actually an amazing experience, one that I will never forget and always remember.
What was it like to work with Julie Bob.
It was great. Which one is she again? I'm kidding.
Anything going on between you two that we should know about?
Well, we're having sex.
That's terrific. Are you signed on to do the prequel?
You're doing a prequel?
Brendan, this is stupid.
Cut.
Sorry. Cut. Brendan?
Yeah?
This is stupid.
No, it's not.
I think it is.
I'm doing a good job.
It's not that you're not doing a good job. I just think the concept is stupid.
Oh, who cares about the concept when I'm doing a good job?
Melissa, don't...
I guess if it's not about you, Melissa, then it's not...
That's not true. I'm thinking about the whole movie.
All right, well, why don't we do this? Jason, you take five. Melissa, we'll do your scene.
Okay.
Hi, Mr. Fieldsmore. It's Paula Small. How are you?
My secretary said this was an emergency.
Oh, it is, Marty. It is. See, I've been working on a book for about 8 years now.
Yeah, you're a slow reader.
That's funny.
Thank you.
I should clarify and say I've been writing a book for 8 years, and I think it's ready. I'd love for you to read it. I mean, you haven't read anything of mine in, what, probably 10 years?
Who is this?
Paula Small.
I know that, but who the hell is Paula Small?
You represented me when I wrote a couple of articles for Out of Ink magazine. Anyway, after that, I got married, and I had a couple kids and taught creative writing. Mm. And in all that time, I have never stopped working on my novel.
Well, I admire your perseverance, Paula, but that's about it. And just for the record, I have never talked to you before in my life.
What?
You dealt with my father.
Oh, I didn't know he had a son.
Yeah, he didn't tell a lot of people.
Oh, well, can I speak with your father then?
Not right now. He's dead.
Julie, your career has taken quite a turn.
Oh my gosh, yeah, lots of turns and curves, too.
You now command the highest fee of any actress in the history of actressing. To what do you attribute your success?
They're called boobs, Pat.
Ha ha ha. But you weren't Simon Spielberg's first choice for the role of Lucy.
No, I wasn't.
Were you?
I wasn't. You've
no,
done
you
your
weren't.
Research.
Yes, I have. They're on these little blue cards.
Brendan, this is stupid.
Oh, now that I'm doing it, it's stupid?
Yeah.
When you did it, it wasn't stupid, but now it's stupid.
Well, no, the difference is that I was doing a decent job.
According to you.
Well, you're also playing a fairly stereotypical character.
Jason, stop looking at my fake boobs.
I can't move my eyes.
So that's basically it. It's a story of sex, murder, extortion, revenge, blackmail, and sex. What do you think?
Send me your draft and I'll read it.
Oh, great. This is great. But let me just touch it up a bit.
Paula, I'm going on vacation for 4 weeks, so I'll read it when I come back.
Oh, no. I have waited so long. Please take it with you on vacation and read it, please.
Okay, but I'm leaving tomorrow night. It's 6 o'clock.
I'll get it to you. I just want to punch it up
a little bit. Okay, okay. Just get it over here by 6 o'clock,
Don't
okay?
worry. I'll drop it off myself.
I'm not worried, Paula. It doesn't make any difference to me one way or another.
Well,
Paula.
Yeah.
I'm hanging up.
Okay, well, I'll bring it. Oh, bye.
Brendan.
Yeah?
What's wrong with your mom? Why won't she pose as my girlfriend,
She's not really into going out.
Who wants to sign a petition?
Yeah, who wants to sign our petition? Yeah.
What's it for?
Because they're cutting down the old elm tree in town center.
And we want to save it.
Yay! Save it!
That tree is an eyesore. Good riddance. Get rid of trees.
Isn't it, like, old and dying?
Yeah.
Why do you guys want to save it anyway?
Because that tree has been there a long time, and we want future generations to enjoy it, too.
Also. And everybody, we peed on it one time.
Perry, don't tell them that.
I mean, we never pee on it.
No, we didn't pee on it.
All we need is 10,000 signatures by today at 6 o'clock, and they won't cut the tree down. Yay!
10,000, that's a lot.
How many signatures do you guys have?
We have, 670.
But you guys, all those names are yours.
Yeah.
You're supposed to get other people to sign it.
No, you're not.
No, you can't just have 400 Walters and 400 Perrys.
But yes, as long as there's signatures.
There's signatures.
I don't think that's how it works.
Yes, that's what they said.
I think they're supposed to be different people.
Why don't you guys just finish signing them, then? Why do you need us to sign them?
Because... my hand hurts.
Mine does, too.
Hey, Coach, it looks like we got some time here. Do you want to be in my mockumentary?
No.
It's like a fake documentary.
No, I know what a mockumentary is, Brendan. Yeah. I don't want to be in it. All right?
All right. Can I give you a script?
No.
Well, let's give him a script.
All right, here's the script, Coach. You're playing an actor who gets killed in the first minute of the movie.
Hey, Brendan, I said I wasn't doing it.
Tell him what the name of the movie is.
It's called Movie History.
So what's it about, the history of movies or something?
No, that's a joke title. The idea is that the director changed the name from Planet Battles to Movie History so he can say he's making movie history.
No, well, I don't like joke titles.
Yeah, me neither.
So I'm interviewing you, and your name is Brad Badman, okay? Melissa, roll it.
Brendan, I'm not doing it.
Action.
So, Brad, you get killed
Brendan,
40 minutes.
Brendan, turn your camera off.
So, Brad.
Should I turn the camera off?
No, turn the camera off.
So, Brad, you get killed 40 seconds into the movie. Did that bother you?
Coach, you're Brad.
Yeah, you're Brad.
How long are you going to do this, Brendan?
It's, really, it's a real short scene. If you just
start with no.
Just start with no. Well, I mean, everybody.
And action.
So, Brad, you get killed 40 seconds into the movie. Did that bother you?
Brendan, tell me why should I do this?
Because you look good on it. You look good.
Well, what's in it for me?
Copy. Mm? Copy for your demo reel.
Helping out kids?
Helping out kids.
What if, Brendan, you get your mom to come with me on Friday night to meet my sister, and then I'll do your movie part?
Okay, how about this, Coach?
Yeah.
I will try as hard as I can to talk to my mother to get her to go with you to the airport.
If I do this part?
If you do the part.
All right.
So, Brad, you get killed 40 seconds in the movie.
Wait, so who am I here?
Brad.
Which one is that?
Brad Badman.
All right, now what am I doing? Why?
There are words underneath each time it says Brad.
Right.
Just read those words.
Let's change my name. How about that?
We can't really do that because we make references to it.
So what? Just change it. I'll just say my name's Jeff.
But tell him the last name, Brendan.
It's Brad Badman.
No, it's Jeff Schwartz.
Okay. So, Jeff, you get killed 40 seconds in the movie. Did that bother you? It's on the script.
Where?
We're on page 17.
It's where it says Brad.
Oh, right. Well, let's change it to Jeff so I know what I'm reading here. All right, I'll mark it off. Melissa, give me a pen.
Here.
Can you get the man a pen, please?
Here.
All right, mark it up. All right, good. All right.
Okay.
So go ahead.
All right.
So and action.
So, Brad.
Jeff.
Can I see the pen?
Here.
Thank you.
Take two.
So, Jeff, you get killed 40 seconds into the movie. Did that bother you?
No. Well, I mean, everybody wants to be in a movie for more than 40 seconds, but when you think about with the shortest attention spans... Today, 40 seconds is, a long time.
Brad, did you...
Melissa, give me the pen. I forgot to change one. Brad.
You know what? It's starting to rain. Why don't we just cut?
That's a wrap.
Well, I'm not done yet. I still got a couple more lines,
I think we're all set.
Yeah, what do you want?
Perry.
Jeez, hideous.
What are you mumbling about?
Nothing.
Well, what do you want?
Tell her, Walter.
Speak up.
Let's both tell her.
Okay.
Miss, would you like to sign a petition to keep the big elm tree?
No.
Rude.
Paula, there's a compromise, all right? I take a few pictures. I'll show my sister. She'll smile. Everybody's happy. No harm done. You don't leave your house.
Look, I got to get this done, all right? I'm trying to concentrate.
Look, Paula, just say yes, and I'll stop bothering you about it.
I'm kind of busy here.
Brendan, tell your mom what I did for you today.
You bought me a cup of coffee.
Good.
No, I'm talking about the movie thing, Brendan.
Oh, yeah. Mom, Coach helped me with the movie today.
Okay. Yeah, see?
He helped me out, okay, Mom?
Okay, fine. You win. I'll do it, all right?
All right, great. That's all I need. This is great.
Right. Okay, how about this? Coach, go over by my mom.
All right.
Just lean in a little bit.
Do you mind?
Yeah. Okay. Just take it.
Okay. Now smile. You guys look so stiff. You look like a couple of hot dogs.
All right. I'll put my arm around.
Okay. How's that?
Okay. A little bit closer. I'm sorry. This looks terrible.
Okay. I'm sorry, but I thought this was going to take a lot less time than it's taking.
Just. Okay. Just you want one natural picture. Looks like
that natural.
Just take it, Brendan.
Okay. Ready? And there we go. Now be goofy with each other, all right? Be like, hey, we have a lot of fun.
Yeah, that's a good idea, Brendan. Like, pretend like we're happy.
Act like you just told a joke and something's really funny.
Yeah, okay. Or you know what's...
I wasn't
laughing, Brendan.
Okay, that was good. That one was not fair.
Look at this.
Well, because that one looks like she's laughing at me.
Okay, how about this? Mom, I hate to do this to you.
Uh-huh.
You're sitting on Coach's lap.
That's not a bad idea.
Yeah, just sitting like, here we are.
Yeah, so hop up here. Paula.
Just real quick?
Uh-huh.
Really natural?
Yeah.
Got it. Let me see.
All right, Paula, so you'll be back in time for me to go to the airport, right?
Yeah, I'm just going to be like
that's
an hour.
That's a necessity.
Right, no, I know.
I got to get there.
Brendan, be good.
Oh, mother.
Jason and Melissa, do what Coach McGurk tells you to do.
Yes, Mrs. Small.
Bye, my precious.
Bye, my precious.
The storm looks pretty bad. Everyone better be prepared. The storm looks like it's going to hit us hard.
Brendan.
What?
Hold on to your sister, will you?
No way. I don't take care of that.
What do you mean, no way?
That's not my bag.
I don't know how to hold a baby.
Neither do I.
Well, we got trouble, then.
Well, it's not my job. You're the one that said that you would do this, not me.
Does she have a pen or something?
She's got a little cage, I think.
You know what? I got an idea.
What?
Get me some rope.
All right.
I'll tie her to the couch.
directing a movie isn't just about yelling action or cut. Sometimes I yell good morning or good night, depending on the time of day. That's what, next question.
Nah.
What?
No.
No, but
Brendan, Melissa and I were talking.
Okay.
Yeah, we think this mockumentary is a crockumentary.
I gave her that one.
We want to do something else.
Cut. What are you guys talking about?
We'd rather be making the movie we're mocking in the mockumentary movie. We just think that the actual movie we're doing now about the mockumentary isn't as good as the movie we're mocking. Do you know what I mean?
I think what she's saying is we'd rather be making the movie that we're making with the mockumentary movie
right.
instead of the movie we're making.
Exactly. Right.
You guys would be rather mocking the movie that we're making in the mockumentary than mocking the movie that we're making right now, which is the mockumentary movie.
Exactly.
Or would you be rather mocking the mockumentary movie and making that movie or making the inside mockumentary movie of the mockumentary?
No, we'd rather not be mocking in a mockumentary, but make the movie that we're mocking in the mockumentary.
She'd rather make the movie you're mocking in the mockumentary rather than the movie that you're making that is a mockumentary.
No, we'd rather make the making of the mocking the mockumentary movie.
I'm getting two stories from you guys. He's saying he wants to make a mockumentary of the making of the mockumentary movie that is about the other, what?
That's not what he means.
I'm saying I want to make it the making of.
No, Jason, that's not what we talked about.
That's what I want to do.
Well, I pitched you guys nixed that a long time ago. The making of a mockumentary of a mockumentary movie that has a movie inside of it, right?
Which is essentially a mockumentary. Correct.
Yes. All I'm saying is I want to make movie history.
Boring.
How did this happen? Oh, Josie, don't be afraid of the thunder. Don't, please, don't cry. There's nothing bad about thunder. It's just a noise. Lightning is what kills you. Like, thousands of people every year die from getting hit by lightning. Or, what else can kill you? Sometimes food can kill you. Raw pork.
Attention, this is an actual emergency. A tornado warning is in effect right now. This is a tornado alert. Get to a shelter or a basement immediately.
Oh my God. Oh my God, what do we do? Brendan? Melissa? Yeah. Jason?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is that his name?
Mm-hmm.
A tornado's coming.
Coach, are you crying?
No, I'm not crying.
Wait, Coach, is tornadoes really coming?
Yeah, that's what the radio said. There's a tornado coming. So I'm gonna stay down here with the baby. You guys go upstairs and play.
Shouldn't we stay down here with you?
No. It's not safe for everybody to be in the same place during a tornado, Melissa.
But I thought you're supposed to go to
No, the rule is, Melissa, you separate.
Are you sure?
Yeah. You get sucked into the funnel, and everyone's separated. It's just like a fun ride. But if you're all in a group, in a cluster, you start banging into each other, and then your heads collide, and you die.
Wow.
Oh, my God, I gotta check on my sister's flight.
What's the matter, Coach?
Her flight's been rerouted. I'm not gonna see her after all.
Sorry.
All that work, all those pictures, and then a tornado comes in and ruins it.
Sorry, Coach.
Oh, well, what are you gonna do? It was probably better anyway. You have to have a death wish to drive in this weather. I mean, it's a tornado. That's like suicide.
Coach?
Yeah? Oh, man. Brendan.
Yeah.
Sorry about your mom. I'm sure she's fine. She took driver's ed, right?
What the hell am I? I'm okay. Take a breath. Oh my God. All right, relax. Oh my God, what time is it? No! Oh!
I think you're really getting carried away, Coach.
So you took it personally, Brendan.
No, I didn't.
It's nothing against you, Brendan.
I know.
I'm just saying, if we have to start eating each other, I'm gonna go for Jason first.
Right.
Then you.
All right.
Then Melissa.
Okay.
Then the baby.
Finally. Here, hold her for a minute.
What was that all about, Jason? You were on the phone for like 20 minutes.
Well, I told my mom I was at your house, Brendan. She said, Brendan, who? So I had to tell her who you were, that we're best friends, that we make movies. And then she asked me what kind of movies. And I said, like, I don't know, little fun movies. Like, real movies, but shorter. And then she said, like, what? And I explained a couple of the movies we made. And then I told her about the one we're making now, the mockumentary.
Right.
And then she said, oh, I like mockumentaries, like Spinal Tap. And I said, I don't know what that is.
Jason, you never told her about me?
No.
What about me?
No.
Come on, somebody.
A tornado can drive a 3-inch nail into a tree, all right?
So it hammers a nail into a tree.
Well,
big deal.
That is a big deal.
I don't see why it's such a big deal.
Could you hammer a nail into a tree by just blowing on it?
No.
That's what a tornado does. It blows on a nail, and the nail goes into the tree.
still don't think it's a big deal.
Why?
What do you mean, why?
Why
would I just put nails in trees?
Yeah.
What's the point?
To mark them.
You mean, like, so I can hang a little sign on it?
Oh, the police, thank God.
Would you like to sign a petition to save the big elm tree?
Yeah! Walter, Perry, what are you doing out in this weather? Get in here!
No, because we only need 4 more signatures to save the big elm tree!
Get in the car!
But we need to save the tree! Perry?
Yeah?
Was that the elm tree?
Yeah.
Okay, so who's in favor of dropping the mockumentary? Okay. Who's in favor of doing the mockumentary? Okay, good. Now we're getting somewhere.
You see, I'm taking out all that stuff about the murder and the sex, and I'm making it into a children's book.
All right.
It's going to be about a sparrow and a cockroach who get lost during a storm and end up going on this wild adventure together.
Sounds trite.
It sounds like that's been done before.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Lame.
Yeah, double lame-o.
Lame.
Double lame-o donkey d-
sucking right on the witch's d-
The storm is past, I repeat. The storm is over. It's safe to come out of your shelters.
Yay!
Wait. Could be a trick.
Paula, you should write a story about when me and Perry grow up.
And we're men!
We're men.
Men!
Well, I'll think about that one.
And call it having fun with Walter and Perry.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good idea. I think I'll stick with the sparrow and the cockroach.
No, write it about Perry and I.
Yeah.
Write it about Perry.
No, maybe I'll write that in my next one.
No.
No.
Write a book about Walter and Perry.
Okay, I'll write a little book
about Walter. Write a book about Perry and I.
No!
You know
what?
No!
Oh my God, am I glad to see you. The police are here, kids. The police are here. So I'm so glad I never made it to Mr. Fieldmore's office. You might say that storm saved my life. My literary life.
Wow.
John, thanks for being here with the kids. I mean, they must have been so glad you were here. Are you all right?
Yeah, what are we wrapping up?
So when movie history opened with the biggest box office draw in movie history, we knew that we had made movie history with movie history. And now I'd like to say something to all the young directors out there. If you want to make movie history, just make sure you own the camera.
Cut. Cut and print. Perfect.
Thank you.
You should make a movie about Perry and I.
Yeah.
Well,
make a movie about Perry and I.
Well,
yeah.
I mean,
Make a movie about Perry and I.
Grab his arms.
Cheesier chips, that nacho cheese taste, that big crunch, nothing even comes close. Gotta get Doritos.
Freshman.
There's something evil in my house.
On April 15th, the windows are the eyes to its soul. The Amityville Horror, rated R, starts Friday, April 15th.
We'll be right back.
Just think of it as a hairy recliner.
Oh!
Thanks a lot, you're beautiful. Except you, lady, you're a freaking schnauzer in pumps. I'm serious, is that your face or did your butt open a branch office?
Oh!
Bada bing, bada bang, bada boom! Thank you, ladies and jerks. Hey, we got a guy up next. I'm looking at him now. And that reminds me, my doctor needs a stool sample.
Oh! Fake an orgasm for Iggy Katalpa!
That wasn't very nice.
Hey, I'll cry tomorrow. You know, I never seen glasses on a turd before.
Oh!
Thank you. I'm Iggy Katalpa. I was checking my wallet like I forgot. So I'm very happy to be here. But then I'm happy to be here. I mean, anywhere. I'm happy to be anywhere. I hope none of you were offended by Mr. Roulette. He just forgets that, well, sometimes you can hurt people, and the best laughter comes from good, clean, inoffensive fun.
You suck!
You'll regret that when you, think better of it. Oh, sorry to be so harsh. So this medical caregiver of indeterminate gender, because nurses can be male or female, says to his or her disabled, or should I say differently abled patient, why do you have a penguin on your head? They're endangered. Ha! Ha!
Drop dead, Geekenstein!
I'm sorry, I'm doing my best. Hey, don't do that, please. Gee, I'd give anything if I could make an audience laugh.
Talk about an outrage! My life insurance is canceled! Why would they drop me?
Could it be because you attempted to defraud them 10 times last month by falsely reporting your own death?
Don't guess at things you can't be sure of! There's good news, though. I may have found an answer. Life is cheap.
Tell me about it. Just last week, I was in a bar talking to a white slaver and...
No. Life is cheap insurance company. This was on my doorstep. Listen. Complete and mail the enclosed do-it-yourself physical to qualify for the most easy-to-afford and erratic life insurance available. Beats the heck out of some quack charging me through the bill just to grow up a bunch of places I don't even touch. Hardly ever. Says I need another person's help, though, someone with at least a minimal amount of medical knowledge.
I graduated with honors from the Universidad de Medicina in Peru.
But you're the son of poor Rocky Mountain Pigs. How'd you afford med school?
2 words. Vivisection volunteer. Sure, it hurt, but I'm told as a result of banging me on the head with a large hammer and then slicing open my stomach and digging around in my insides, they were able to rule out 2 theories on why fat people perspire.
Worthy cause. So, shall we get on with it?
Bend over, grab the desk, and grit your teeth.
Wait a minute. Does it say we have to do this?
Never mind. It appears that you suffer from high blood pressure induced by stress.
High blood pressure? Induced by stress? That's terrible news! I hate getting terrible news! I hate it!
It says here, in case of stress-induced high blood pressure, take enclosed pill. Then relax, kick your webs up, and have a few laughs.
A few laughs. Yeah, if only there was something to bring a few laughs into my life.
Mr. Duckman, 4 comedians here to see you.
If only there was something to bring a few busty, leather-clad, thrill-seeking ex-nuns into my life.
It was worth a shot.
Ay-ow! Confed! Look! My 4 favorite comedians and one of their marginally talented husbands! What are you doing here?
That's the second time I heard that today. The first was when I woke up in bed next to my wife.
I don't believe it! Carney, this is Roulette.
How you doing? You remind me of a chick I once porked.
Oh! I love it! He offends everyone! This is Dennis Shandberg. He finds humor in everyday lives!
Why do they call it porking? I mean, when pigs do it, do they call it peopling?
Get it? It's funny because it's obvious! This is Roxanne and her husband. What's his name?
John! How you do-
See, John, I told you men were pigs.
She's right, Corny. When you think about it, we all are pigs. And this is Marvin. He played the street smart yet non-threatening black surgeon married to a corporate lawyer living in Beverly Hills with his garbage man father and overweight mother on the sitcom Ain't Life a Bitch.
What up, what up, what up? Look, white skin, black skin, pig skin, we all after the same thing. Making bacon.
So true, so true.
We need you to solve a case for us.
Us? Solve a case? That's a good one. Boy, that's absurd. That's really...
Oh. You're serious?
Well, then you've come to the right duck. Who's the pile you want me to scoop up?
Iggy Katalpa, comedian. He's stealing our audience.
Huh?
He's too good.
No one wants to hear us.
What we want is for you to dig up some dirt on him. There's gotta be something you can find to get rid of him.
Look, gang, I don't know. I mean, there's no law against someone being funny. Maybe he's just got something new or special or different about his humor.
It's clean!
Clean? I can't let a low-down scum like that put you guys out of work. This world's depressing enough without a few insults, slurs, and good honest laughs at other people's expense. A case like this, you take for the principal. And any favors, freebies, and groupie phone numbers you can throw my way.
We'll give you some fake vomit and a whoopee cushion.
Throw in an ice cube with a fly in it, and you got yourself a deal.
I love these things.
I can't wait to meet this guy, Corny. I'm gonna give his past a once-over he'll never forget. Get the dirt beneath the dirt. They don't call me the Dustbuster for nothing.
Who calls you the Dustbuster?
People.
Who?
Okay, no one, but after this they will.
Who will?
Never mind! Wow, you hear that, Corny? Those guys were right. This guy must be incredible. Let's go see.
A differently abled person goes to a medical caregiver of indeterminate gender, and the caregiver says, "Why do you have a penguin on your head? They're endangered."
Funny.
This must be some kind of joke, because that sure wasn't.
It's all going according to plan.
I can't believe you thought that guy was funny. I had math classes funnier than him, and I couldn't even sleep through this. I gotta find something that'll take him down. Chances are he won't talk to a detective, so I brought a disguise. Voila! Not bad, huh?
Hey, where'd Duckman go? I was just talking to him, and suddenly, poof, he was gone, and a complete stranger was standing in his place.
Fine, make mock if you like. But this is perfect. People open doors for reporters, they won't open for anyone else.
If you're a reporter, I'm not opening the door. Kidding. I heard what you said. It screamed for a payoff. Come in, mister.
Duckman, Duckman N. Disguise. And this is my assistant.
Pat Corcoran.
That's the best you could do. Yeah, we're reporters for the Sun, Sentinel, Globe, Tribune, Times, Herald, Picayune.
So much for their front page. But seriously, last time I talked to a reporter, he said, "Any words for the press?" And I said, "Yeah, get a real job, 1, 2, 3. But hey, enough about you. Mo Needleman, formerly the Wizard of One-Liners on the Boyce Belt Circuit, now Iggy Katalpa's personal manager and all-round yenta.
Huh?
It's Yiddish. An older generation of comics uses it to further distance itself from a young audience.
Ah.
Young schmung. Comedy changes, but funny never does. Ask me about my date to the senior prom.
What happened with your date to the senior prom?
She canceled to go to a wedding. Her own. Ha-boom. I said, "What? You can't do both?" Ba-boom. Funny 40 years ago. Funny now. What am I, talking in tongues? You're looking at me like my Aunt Sophie did when I told her I was playing hide the crip lock where the chicks are. Ba-dum boom. Which reminds me, can you believe those airlines?
Needleman, take a breather. We're here to do a story on Iggy.
You never heard of warming up a crowd? Igala, we have people. Come join.
Hi, everyone. Look what Mo got me. It's a robe with my initials on it. Gee, this is the best gift I ever got, assuming no animals were killed to make it.
Course not. The ones they used was already dead. But I want to tell you, Iggy, this is Mr. Corcoran and Mr. Disguise. They're reporters, and they want to do a story on you.
On me? That's even neater than the robe. No offense to the gift, of course. There's no reason to praise the story by tearing down the robe's self-esteem.
Such bilk as I get from them. Couldn't you just plot?
Yeah, all over the carpet. I've got some questions for Iggy.
Subtlety is the key to getting the dirt we want, Corny.
So, Iggy, it must be a bit heady basking in all this glory, especially after your earlier days as a male hustler, was it?
What?
Not to mention those run-ins with the authorities over that baby-selling ring.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And what about that story linking you to the international drug cartel?
Mo, what's he doing?
A smear job, kid, but he's wasting his ink. He lives as clean as he wakes, disguised, and that's why he's going all the way to the top. I've seen them all, and Iggy's the best there's ever been.
What are you, nuts? What about Foulmouth Jackson? Billy Bananas Bonetti? Or how about when Spooky Dan used to hit Officer Barry with a flaming axe? Oh, boy, that was comedy.
They didn't last, and you know why? Because you didn't feel better when it was over. There's only one way I can explain it. Tickle the ivories.
I spent a year and a half in the tiki room at the Toledo Holiday Inn.
Play, Gypsy, play! There's a wild, funny feeling that you feel inside when it comes bubbling out. Ha ha! It sends your senses reeling. It can't be denied. And it comes spurting out. Ha ha! Take all the world's money, increase it by half, then offer it to me, I'd still rather laugh. There's no bigger pisser than a pie in the kiss as it comes gushing out. Ha-ha!
Does it aim to please?
Ha-ha!
Is it always in threes?
Ha-ha! When life gets too tough for me and deals bad stuff for me, it's more than enough for me to laugh. People are filled with hate and burdened by sorrow's weight, so please, if it's not too late, just laugh.
It's the only reaction to the thunderous din when you can't help yourself.
Ha ha! It's a self-satisfaction. If you have it, you win. So get off of the shelf.
Winners and losers through pleasure and pain. Just love Mishigas, Hostamul Gazane.
From Maine to Kathmandu.
This man and that man too.
Can't do without, can you?
Ha ha! It's the antidote for your end, you'll note that you can't, you don't, puff and pant by rote. When laughter takes over, you're rolling in clover. It's comedy! And they call it... Ha! Ha! Now do you get it?
Hi, Duckman. You're home late.
That's it? No zinger about what a lousy father I am? No one-liner about how either I just walked in or a garbage truck overturned in our living room?
Iggy Catalpa says insult humor's passé.
Atoo, Bernice! What's happening here? This guy's taking over. He's everywhere.
Excuse us, Mr. Disguise?
I'm even starting to hear his voice in my own home!
Iggy!
Howdy, pre-adults. I love performing for young people, especially if they're duly capitated.
This is where you say, do you know what time it is? And I say, time to get a new lock on your door. Try to keep up. But seriously, forgot to give you these back at the club. Two backstage passes to my boy's maiden appearance next week on Drum Roll, Please, the Late Night Tonight Show.
All right.
Mr. Catalpa, may I say what a joy it is to see someone like you succeed using humor that doesn't degrade anyone who's the slightest bit different from himself.
Oh, right. Like I was the only one to laugh at the joke about the gay midget with a cleft palate.
Morris Needleman, Iggy's mentor, but you can call me Mo, as in Mo Knows Comedy.
Oh, Mo knows charm, too.
Mo's gonna want to know a good lip doctor when he finds out where that hand's been.
Speaking of disgusting, why did the congressperson almost regurgitate? Because he or she got inebriated on power. I usually don't do satire.
Pardon me, Tsatskala. May we use your bedroom?
That joke usually does so well.
The joke's fine, you're just running a little low.
If you think I'm so funny, how come I gotta drink this stuff?
Audiences are stupid. You gotta force them to like the right things. Now get out there and murder them with laughter.
And speaking of laughter, the last laugh's gonna be on you, Duckman.
And he turned to her and he said, well, ma'am, it's better than a pubic hair in your Coke. Not, of course, the kind of joke meant for our constituents. For what is our job if not to legislate a different set of standards for our citizens than we set for ourselves? The answer lies in the Iggy Act, which states that all jokes told publicly must be as nice as Iggy's.
But wouldn't that violate the constitutional right to free speech?
Thank heavens for Whiteout.
Iggy. It's driving me out of my mind. Every single person I know loves him, and he isn't funny. Funny is a wiffle ball bat in the gazangas, or a little super glue on a toothbrush, or this all-occasion pocket insulter.
Put a sack on it and slam it in a door.
Actually, I find the politically correct Iggy Catalpa pocket comforter much funnier.
We sometimes disagree, but it doesn't mean we can't hug.
It's over. Without laughter, I don't know what's left.
I might as well go backstage, wish him luck.
Maybe I could learn to like him. Why's that penguin on your head? They're endangered. Oh, boy. What's the use? I still don't get them. I never will.
Eagler, go autograph some pictures for those orphans. So, Duckman, now that you've seen my secret, it's me, your arch nemesis, King Chicken.
Whoa! Why are you strapping me down? What are you gonna do to me?
Relax. You've got the best seat in the house.
Well, I appreciate the compliment, but I don't swing that way.
No, you simpering idiot. You still don't see, do you? I did all this for you. When we were school children together, it was you who taunted me, who humiliated me, who got the other children to laugh at me. But things have changed. You're the outcast now. After tonight, you'll know what it's like to have the whole world laugh and to not be able to laugh with it.
But how?
Do you ever wonder what makes someone funny?
Hey, what happens?
Like a ability! I created a formula that gives its user instant charisma. One gulp and that walking oatmeal seemed like a comic genius. No one could resist him, except you.
Of course, because I was too worldly and sophisticated to be so easily duped.
No, because you were such a moron. You took the antidote for the formula. Only you would fall for that idiotic do-it-yourself home physical I sent for that phony baloney life insurance company, taking that so-called pill that did absolutely nothing for your high blood pressure.
You mean I'm not insured?
Egad, but you're an imbecile. Well, 3 minutes to showtime.
Consider this concert one last bit of misery before I come back and finish you off.
Hope I like the warm-up act.
And if I sit with you gorgeous.
Help!
Let me get you out of there.
Wow, yelling help never works.
I'm non-union.
It's time for the moment you've all been waiting for.
Iggy, wait!
Hey, Mo, Mr. Disguise told me everything, and I don't think it's very...
Get out there, you schmendrin! The red liquid's my intelligence formula!
I know you all came here to see Iggy Catalpa because you think he's funny, because you like his style, because you're just plain like him, right?
Yeah!
But you just think you do, because you were manipulated into thinking you do by him, King Chicken. He did it the same way they manipulate us into buying toothpaste, car wax, even politicians. All prepackaged, the least offensive, most appealing alternative. But it's precisely when humor is offensive that we need it most. Comedy should provoke. It should blast through prejudices, challenge preconceptions. Comedy should always leave you different than when it found you.
The rabble seems roused.
Sure, humor can hurt, even alienate. But the risk is better than the alternative. A steady diet of innocuous, childproof, flavorless mush.
demand to be challenged, to be offended, to be treated like thinking, reasoning adults. And raise your children to be the same. Don't let a comedian, a network, a congressional committee, or an evil genius take away your freedom to laugh at whatever you want.
Exit. Stage left.
Don't think you've seen the last of me yet, Duckman.
Wow, Doc.
That was incredible. I never heard you be so passionate and eloquent.
Yeah, well, it was because I accidentally swallowed King Chicken's intelligence formula.
The stuff I was drinking? Actually, Mr. Disguise, that was just cherry soda.
Look, Iggy, I'm sorry I had to expose him like that and bring your world crashing down around you.
Me too. Well, guess it's time to move on to my lesbian jokes. Hey, whatever works.
I think everything's gonna be all right. Boom, 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 boom. When it comes bubbling up.
I'll take a Whopper.
Do you desire your pyrotechnically prepared beef to be customized with the addition or subtraction of key ingredients?
No onions, extra pickles.
And do you wish to be transformed into a two-dimensional character with yellow skin?
Woohoo!
We have here what appears to be an alien invasion.
And the line between civilization and anarchy is eroding as
we... Out of my way, you punks!
Wow! Lunchtime!
Yeah, I gotta get out of here.
Extra pickle, extra ketchup, extra mustard.
How about extra get lost?
What? What's going on?
Aliens have all the fun. Your Highness, your mission is complete.
The world is going Simpsons, and BK is in on it.
There's something new inside Hershey's Kisses. Smooth, creamy peanut butter. New Hershey's Kisses filled with peanut butter. It's the taste you'll go nuts for.
We tried to find new ways to make eating yogurt a lot more fun, like using a trombone.
Didn't work.
Or an umbrella.
Didn't work.
Or a cell phone.
Didn't work!
Then we hit upon a great idea. Cookies!
Yeah, it works!
Introducing Kemp Spoons and Yogurt. It comes with 12 spoons you can actually eat. It's more fun than a hockey stick. New Spoons and Yogurt from Kemp's.
Consume a spoon!
We're off now. We're flying. And there's no denying. We're driving.
Home.
Yeah, give me a born-again burger, some Nazareth nuggets, and a Judas juice.
Wanna crucify that?
Yeah, make that too, Mary. And throw in a Pontius Apple Pilot.
Bless you. That'll be $7.90. Pull around to the collection plate.
All right, Gary, you get the $7, I got the $90.
Forget it, Mike. I'm not buying you lunch again.
Oh, then let's call it dinner.
Come on, man. You need to start carrying your own weight. Get a job.
Sorry, brother. Work is like cuddling after sex. I just don't do it.
No big deal about getting a job.
That's how they get their claws into you, man. As soon as you get that first paycheck, it's all over. You start to want stuff. Suddenly, you're a 9-to-5 sucker, slaving away for enough scratch to pay off the rent on your double wide. Works for losers, Gary.
You know, you could be a great motivational speaker. Mike Bonner's Guide to Poverty in Just 10 Easy Steps. You know, make it 9 easy steps because you'd quit before you got to 10.
You're kind of funny.
Thanks.
You new in town?
Yeah, we're just passing through.
Well, I hope you pass through again, Gary.
Well, thanks. Wendy?
Man, she was all over you like fat on a freshman.
Don't try and change the subject.
I'm telling you, she said your name.
Gary.
You let this slip by and you leave me no choice but to question your sexuality.
All right, fine. I'll ask her out if you get a job.
You're on.
Hi, Wendy. You remember me? You gave me some very delicious food about a minute ago. Gary.
I was thinking, you know, maybe me and you could, I don't know, we could go out for a burger or, oh man, that's so stupid, you're in the industry.
No, I'd love to. Pull around to the collection plate.
Here's my address.
Oh, way to score, Gar.
Pick me up tomorrow night.
Well, should I pick you up at your drive-thru window or pull around to your front door?
Bye, Gary.
Dios mío.
I hear you, Mike. She's hot in any language.
Are you crazy? Didn't you see that freak on her cheek?
You mean the beauty mark?
That's what you're calling that furry duffel bag hanging off her mug? Whew. I used to say it all looks the same in the dark, but trust me, there's no room dark enough for that beast.
I don't care what you say, Mike. I think she's cute. And even if she wasn't, it wouldn't matter because it's what's on the inside that counts.
All the insides in the world couldn't get me past that outside.
Oh, I see what you're doing. You're trying to weasel out of your end of the deal. No way, Mike. You're getting a job.
Oh, I've got a job. Saving you from Chewbacca.
No, Mike, you're getting an honest-to-God, 9-to-5, punch-in, punch-out, want-to-blow-your-brains-out type job. There's no such thing as a free ride, Michael.
What's this all about there, Hopalong?
Well, all you gotta do is keep one hand on this here car. You get 5-minute break every 3 hours. The last person standing with their hand still on her takes her home.
This is not a real job, Mike.
What are you talking about? All I have to do is just stand here for a few hours and walk away with a brand new ride? Ha! That's the kind of job that Mikey likes.
Here he is, y'all, the 5-time hands on a hot rod winner, Mr. Denny Dennis.
Double D hears a voice.
What's it say?
What's that? Are you talking to Daddy? Uh-huh. It sounds like this baby here wants to come home with me. Well, all right then. It's settled. Double D is winning this baby hands down.
All right, folks, here we go. On your mark.
Forget it, Mike.
I'm doing it.
Get set.
You'll never win.
Watch me.
Hands on a hot rod.
Hey there, stranger. This
the first time you put your hands on a hot rod?
Aside from my own? Absolutely.
Well, don't you worry, son. Car standing's a piece of cake.
Less than he's downwind to you, poop sack.
Whoa, whoa, slow down there, Jethro. Isn't that a little bit harsh?
Oh, don't pay Denny no mind. He's just sore because I almost beat him last year. Till my darn colon ruptured. Whew, what a mess. Clean up on aisle me. Hi, I'm Betty.
I'm Mike.
Nice to meet you. Uh-oh.
What's wrong?
I got a rumble in my tumbly. Ever since the colon popped, I'm not sure whether it's gonna come out gas or mass. Good news! Gas.
Hey, aren't you Gary Newton?
Yes, I am.
Oh! There. Now, that's better.
I can't afford these.
Oh, they're on the house. Nothing but the best for our Wendy.
Hey, how'd you know about my date?
Good news travels fast in Wendville.
Hey, good luck on your date, Gary.
Way to go, Gary. Wendy's a lucky girl.
Bless you, Gary. You're doing God's work.
He's Gary Newton, and we're all rooting, come what may. Oh, Gary won't run away.
So from all of us, thank you, Gary Newton.
Three and a half minutes.
You can't hang with the big dogs, boy. Why don't you head on over to the porch with those puppies?
Good one, Double D.
You got no shot here, Tinkerbell. Why don't you try something you're good at, like disappointing your folks?
Yeah, what do you think I'm doing?
Hi, Mike. Hey, Gary. So how's it going?
Great, Gary. Hey, let me introduce you to my friends. This is Loser, and next to him is Ma Loser, there's Pa Loser, and the whole rest of the Loser family.
Ooh, you go on, sassy boy. We'll see how much you got to say tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Ha, 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 huh? Hey, how long does this last?
Oh, about 4 days.
4 days? I mean, this sounds like work.
Oh, Mike, you're not thinking of quitting, are you?
4 days, huh? Bring it on, man!
Oh, it's hotter than blazes out there today. So if you leave your day laborers in the car, roll down them windows, folks. And hey, we're about 15 minutes away from Wendy's big date.
Hola, Wendy and Gary vienen en un noche de amor. Y no importa el grosje de oso de Wendy.
Hi, I'm here to pick up Wendy.
Hi, Gary.
This isn't another gang initiation, is it?
No, just a date.
Oh, come right on in.
Let me get you a stiff drink.
No, thank you.
Gary, you're here. You're really here.
You look beautiful.
Looks like he already had a stiff drink.
Oh, they're lovely. Thank you.
Now, Gary, I want you to know that Wendy's my only daughter, see? So here are the rules. There's no curfew, no limit on my gold card, and as far as taking liberties, the light don't get any greener.
Bye, y'all. Wait, I want to get a picture. Okay, smile.
Oh, my God. Am I having a good time? Okay, we better get going. Bye-bye now.
Yeah, baby. 8 down, 12 to go.
What a rush! Every time someone quits, I feel like I'm back at Kent State dropping hippies.
Good one, Double D.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, will you please shut up?
Oh, hands off! Hands off!
We're not! You liar!
She's out!
Go to hell!
You are!
Sister Marie, you're out!
Never!
Well, where's your God now, sister?
Oh, the happy couple. I'm so glad you've come. Follow me.
Oh,
Wendy, if you please.
I just want to sit close to the kitchen. I'm a Sub-Zero nut.
Enjoy your meal.
This is so nice, Gary. Out on a date at a restaurant. It doesn't happen too often.
Oh, really? Why?
Well, in case you haven't noticed, I have this growth.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that, yeah. I thought it was just the lighting.
Look, Gary, some people have trouble with the way I look, and I just want to make sure you're okay with it.
Oh, of course I'm okay with it. But, well, here's an idea. Have you ever thought about having it removed?
Every time I do, it grows back bigger and darker and hairier than before. But you're okay with it, right?
Okay. I'm beginning to worry if I'll ever be attracted to a girl without a beauty mark.
You know, when you first drove up to Baptist Burger, I could tell you were different. I mean, everything about you was different.
Oh, that thing is hideous. I feel sick to my stomach. Wait a minute. Listen to yourself. You of all people. Just this morning, you said that it's what's on the inside that counts. God, I wonder what could be on the inside of that. Oh, stop! Come on, kid. Get over this. Get to know her. Give her a chance.
And then I got stood up for the prom again.
Oh, well, trust me, after the third time, you don't even feel it.
Well, how about Jim? I always got picked last.
You were picked? Oh, you know what the worst is? Is when they glue your locker shut.
Oh, it's such a pain to get it open.
Especially when you're inside it.
For the sweethearts, two meatloaf specials.
Bon appetit.
And Gary seems to have a touch of the flu. Turning to sports, we're coming up on hour 38 of the Hands on a Hot Rod contest. It's down to three contestants.
Ooh, I feel great. Got my second wind? Make that my third wind.
All right, she's wearing orthopedic shoes. She's got on adult diapers. She's not going anywhere. I've got to outsmart her. All right, think. That's it. She'll never see this coming.
Oh, hey!
You're out!
No, he pushed me!
I didn't touch you, Corn Cob!
You pushed me!
I didn't even go near her!
No.
Liar!
No.
Hey, better luck next year, poop sack!
I, for one, never saw that coming.
Psych! You're next, Double D. There's more where that came from.
Here we are. It's been really great, huh? And again, I'm sorry about the mess. But we should do it again sometime, you know? The thing is, I don't know what my schedule's like this week, so I could give you a call.
Look, Gary, be honest. I repulse you.
No, not at all.
You don't have to lie. I just hope you'd be different, but...
No, Wendy! No, don't cry! No. Listen, your growth doesn't bother me at all.
Honestly?
Cross my heart. In fact, I think it's kind of cute, and it gives you character, and I'd really like to see you again.
You really mean that? How about tomorrow?
Okay.
Great! I can't wait to see you, Gary.
I've got a second date!
Thank you, sweet Jesus! Wendy's got a second date. I'm not lying.
He tried bailing, but Gary's failing, and now he's stuck. He's such a stupid.
Good morning, Wentzville. Hands on a Hot Rod contest is moving into day three. Who'd have thunk it? Mike Bonner has come from out of the blue to give old Double D a real run for his money.
Hey, Mike, I need your help. How do I get out of a date with Wendy without her hating me? If it weren't for the growth, she'd be the perfect girl for me, but she's hideous. So what should I say to her?
Get lost.
Isn't that a little harsh?
No, you get lost.
Yeah, I don't think that softens it very much.
Don't show up. Dump her. I don't care.
No. I know how it feels to be dumped, and it sucks, okay? I couldn't live with myself if I hurt her. See, it's very important for me to understand...
Nothing is more important than winning this car!
Now
get the hell away from me!
Oh my God, what the hell happened to you?
I got a job!
Top you off,
Don't
Gary.
Mind if I do.
So, Gary, what are your plans for the future?
Well, to be honest, I don't really have any, sir. I'm just kind of cruising from town to town right now.
A drifter! You hear that, Mother? Wendy's got herself a drifter!
Get off it, moron! I mean, who's kidding who? Wendy's sporting a hairy eggplant on her grill, and this half-wit loser can't deal!
Grandma!
Well, it's true! It's as clear as that hunk of hairy meat on her face. I mean, why else would he be here? He feels sorry for her.
No, I don't. Wendy's a great girl.
Tuck his sheep. Bottom line is, ain't no one gonna marry this girl.
Hey, that's not true. She has got a lot going for her. She's smart. She's funny. Any guy would be lucky to marry her.
You wouldn't marry her.
Sure I would.
Really?
Did I just hear you right?
Oh, my God. My baby. She's getting married.
And to a drifter.
Hello.
I can't believe it's really happening.
Yeah, I think this calls for a celebration. Bring out the good plastic.
Wait a minute.
Oh, my God.
I just realized that I have never seen your bathroom. Come on, Gary, come on, think. Just be honest, that's the way to get through it. I wonder if I can get through that window. No, Gary, come on, you're bigger than that. How about that window? No, I'm just gonna tell her the truth. Time to do the right thing.
Pants.
Keep it up, boy. I'll drive my house over to your house and kick your ass.
Oh, yeah. I'm really scared of a 55-year-old tub of grease whose daddy loved the Cowboys more than him and whose wife's been getting it on with Max Stoker for the last 48 hours.
What? Terry Lynn? Oh, my God. My sweet Lord. My wife? She's all I have. I love her. This contest is tearing us apart. I've got nothing left. Oh, Daddy, why didn't you love me like you loved Tom Landry?
That's right, Roscoe. You're done. You're over. Give it up. Some kid who's never done this before is beating you at the only thing you've ever been good at. Because I am the king, and this car is mine.
I guess this is it, Bonner. You're about to be a champion. Just like I was. The torch has finally been passed.
No. What have I become? I'm out! I quit!
Double D wins the car!
Woo! Oh, yeah! I am the champion again!
Good one, Double D!
Ha ha! Psych! The old torch has been passed. Routine works every time.
Gary, I thought you were still in the bathroom.
I was. But then I crawled out the window and ran for my life.
I see.
I came back because I have to be honest with Wendy.
What is it, Gary?
Wendy, you're a really great girl, and I like you a lot. But I can't marry you because of your growth. I wish I was a bigger person, but I'm not. I'm so sorry.
You can stop there, Gary.
Wait. The thing.
It's fake.
I don't understand.
I want to make sure that whoever I marry loves me for who I really am, not just my pretty face.
Or the $56 million she's gonna inherit when her grandma dies.
Let me finish. Like I said, I think you're a great girl, I like you a lot, and then I was gonna say, maybe we should go out tomorrow night.
Sorry, Gary. Now that you've shown your true colors, I never want to see you again.
Oh, that hurts.
Oh, and Gary, we're very protective of Wendy's little secret. So if you want to live, keep it a secret. Bye.
Oh, my gosh. It gives this reporter great sadness to have to tell you that our dear Wendy's been left at the altar by Gary Newton. Now, for all you civic-minded people out there, Gary's driving down Main Street right now.
Get out of here now!
So, Gary, I'm guessing the breakup went well?
Not now, Mike.
Don't not know me. Do you know how close I was to winning that hot rod? And I gave it up for you.
Okay, thank you very much. I appreciate it. I owe you one.
Okay, listen, I'll tell you what. You buy me lunch for the rest of the trip, and we'll call it even.
Okay, fine. That's fair.
Psych. The old almost won the hot rod routine. It works every time.
She was just faking, he was mistaken. He's made his bed, now the whole town wants him dead.
You're watching Comedy Central. If you thought freshman year was rough, wait till you see it animated. Stick around for Undergrads, coming up next.
Welcome to our orchard where we get our flavoring worth savoring.
Puffa, puffa, zippity-zah, if you try these goodies, you surely might die.
Right this way, there's someone I'd like you to meet.
Hi there, kids!
Hey, this isn't a candy factory.
I've no regrets that in this factory, we make cigarettes.
Tobacco companies sell products with candy flavors, but don't get tricked into trying them. A message from Rat, reject all tobacco.
You better tell somebody!
Then Boggs replaces your picture phone with dynamite and your head blows clean off.
You do have an extra head, don't you, boy?
No, this is...
Props! It's my commercial! It's my phone! It's mine!
What's the matter, friend? Your phone don't take pictures. Uh-oh.
Smile, Debbie.
So who should we send it to?
Stop the beat of the air,
Picture mail from Sprint. Now at Sprint stores, get a PCS Vision picture phone for $99.99.
Ow!
Twizzlers, play first, eat later.
I am the stone that the builder refused. I am the visual, the inspiration that made ladies sing the blues. I'm the spark that makes your idea bright. The same spark that lights the dark so that you can know your left from your right. I am the ballad in your box, the bullet in the gun, the inner glow that let you know to call your brother son. The story that just begun, the promise of what's to come. And I'ma remain a soldier till the war is won. Chop, chop, chop. Chop, chop, chop.
Watch where you walking, nigga.
Hey, what you say, nigga?
Watch closely. You're about to experience a nigga moment. Webster defines the nigga moment as a moment when ignorance overwhelms the mind of an otherwise logical Negro male.
What did you say, bitch, nigga? Hey, squeeze it, nigga!
Causing him to act in an illogical, self-destructive manner, i.e., like a nigga. Nigga moments are unpredictable.
Hey, wait, man, wait. This is stupid.
Hey, you right, dawg. Look, let's put the guns away and go on about our business.
Freeze!
But they all end up bad. If they had their own category, nigga moments would be the third leading killer of black men behind pork chops and FEMA. It's a fact. Now let's see how a nigga moment affects a white man.
Prick.
Watch where you walking, bitch.
What did you... Wait a minute. I'm white.
Where you going? Don't you ignore me. This is a perfectly good moment to throw your life away.
A big misconception about the nigga moment is that it can be avoided by simply moving away from niggas. If only it were that easy. See, niggas always got a new trick right around the corner.
Listen up, boys. I'm about to sing the new shoe song. New shoes, new shoes. Boy, Nike makes some good shoes.
Ave Maria.
Nobody in my speed under this handicap park.
Son of a bitch.
Every nigga moment begins with the nigga. Without that key element, all you're left with is peace and quiet. Colonel H. Stinkmeaner is and always has been a cantankerous, ornery old man. He has spent his childhood disagreeing with most things, especially things involving happiness, unity, and kindness. Stinkmeaner got no pleasure seeing sunsets and trees, dolphins or rainbows.
Man, this some old bullshit.
So, he didn't particularly mind when at age 15, he lost his sight to cancer.
At least I don't have to look at your glass no more.
The doctors gave him 3 years to live, so he dedicated those 3 years to spreading a lifetime of misery and hatred. Nobody knows how Stinkmeaner managed to live so long. He believed it was his love of hatred that kept him going.
Who in the hell parked in my space? That's like calling 1-800-COLLECTING-ASS-WHOOPING. And no, that ain't no toll-free call, partner.
You hit my car. Are you blind?
Yes, I am. So?
Wait, you're blind?
Yes, blind. You got a problem with that, nigga?
You could have killed somebody.
I'd be doing him a favor. Getting run over by me is as close to an honorable death as most of these people gonna get. Some days, I'm quite the humanitarian. I think I hit a wheelchair on the way over here.
Oh, look what you did to Dorothy. You better have insurance.
Nigga, you better have insurance. Ass-whooping insurance, and you about to pay a deductible.
And just like that, my granddad was trapped in a nigga moment. At this point, he can A, walk away and let insurance handle the damage to the car, or B, fight with a dumb, crazy, blind nigga. Let's see which one he chooses.
That's right. I backed into your car, nigga. What you gonna do? What you gonna do?
Oh, hell no. Granddad, let's whoop this nigga's ass right now.
Bitch-ass, faggot-ass, punk-ass, pussy-ass, bitch-ass, nigga! You wanna do something, bitch-ass, nigga? Hold up. I smell new shoes.
Oh, me. Oh!
Ooh, what you made?
I've said it before. Expensive sneakers are like $150 landmines. Step on one and boom! A perfectly rational black man can explode.
Yeah, they ain't new anymore, are they, nigga?
And that nigga spitting on you, you better hit him, granddad. Hit him, hit him. Yeah, hit him. Oh, what happened?
My bad knee. Oh, lordy, lordy, lord. My knee, my bad knee.
Oh, man, all your pimps, daddy.
This fight is over.
I hate this damn song.
I can't believe you got your ass kicked by a blind man, granddad.
My knee went up. You know I got a bad knee.
Bad knee? That nigga had bad eyes. He couldn't see, granddad. He beat you like a piñata.
No.
Yo, we can rent granddad out for Mexican birthday parties. We can call him Señor Piñata. Hola, Señor Piñata.
Stop it, boy. Stop it. Where's my belt?
Woo! Woo! I must be blind, too, because I sure didn't see that ass movie coming.
Boy.
Yo, how bad you gotta telegraph your purchase for a blind nigga to see you coming, granddad?
Riley, the man obviously had a heightened sense of hearing.
Oh, I thought granddad had a heightened sense of falling.
No, that's enough. Now you just stop laughing at your granddaddy. Ain't dead. What's wrong with you?
Granddad had hit me written on his forehead in braille.
I said that's enough.
Okay. What you gonna do? Beat me? Maybe I should get a blindfold first. Okay, I'm ready. Wait, maybe he gonna fall on me.
Riley, stop!
Granddad, Rodney King just called. He said, damn, I thought I got my ass whooped. Ow!
That night, I dreamt of a blind swordsman.
Poisonous paragraph, smash it on the graph in half. It reads the inspector Jack on the warpath. First class, leaving mites with a cast. Causing ruckus like the aftermath on guns blast. Run fast, here comes the verbal assaulter. Rhymes running wild like a child of the water. I score from the inner slums abroad.
He knows my every move, yet he cannot see. As my mind fights to make sense of the impossible, he has turned my sight into a liability. He has no just cause to want my life. There is no forethought, no logic in his actions. This isn't just any swordsman. This is the blind nigga samurai.
What's good, nigga? What's really good?
Niggas. A nigga moment isn't necessarily over when you think it's over. It kind of hangs around like an unpaid bill.
And in a case of the blind beating the dumb, security cameras from the Woodcrest Square Mall captured a fight between
That's
a blind
lie.
Old
that ain't
man
what happened.
And an unidentified assailant following a parking dispute.
Oh, man.
It's just local news.
CNN has now confirmed that it was this man, Robert Jebediah Freeman, who got beat up by a slightly older, significantly blinder gentleman. Police aren't pressing charges against Mr. Freeman. They say that ass-whooping was punishment enough. We at CNN agree.
Granddad, I don't think you should watch this anymore.
El residente de Woodcrest, Robert Freeman, tiene un nuevo apodo, Señor Piñata. Oh, Patty.
Granddad, you gotta ask yourself, would you really be better off if you had beaten up a blind old man in the street? It was a nigga moment, Granddad. You gotta let it go.
Maybe you're right.
You have reached the Freeman residence. If this is a lovely cutie pie, please leave a message. Everybody else suggests hang up right now because I'm not interested.
Come on, Robert, pick up the phone. Pick up the phone. I know you there in hiding. I seen you on the news getting your black ass whooped by that blind old monkey. That's why they shouldn't let niggas go shopping. Call me back. Don't you walk away from this answering machine.
Granddad, just let it die. I promise you nobody's gonna call you a punk.
I will.
Well, Riley will. Granddad! Granddad went back to fight that man.
Yo! Check this out, Huey. All right. Wait. What? Here it goes. Here it goes. Oh! Hey, you ever notice whenever someone throws a chair, a ball jumps off?
Aren't you worried about Granddad?
Look, you want to see it again? Hey, look, see? I said you don't even have to hit nobody with a chair. And niggas would still start wilding out.
Well, you don't look hurt.
2 weeks.
Good for you. A rematch in 2 weeks. This'll be great. Hey, we might be able to make some money off this. The Slugfest in Woodcrest. Yeah!
You don't understand, boy. I have to do this.
Follow me. I want you to see what you're up against. Way he dodged your punch? Your enemy is the Satoichi, the blind swordsman. His ears give him more information than all your senses put together. If you underestimate him, he will kill you. You must train.
I won't fail you. I'm not afraid.
Oh, you will be. You will be.
And
between me and you, your granddaddy shouldn't be too worried. Everybody knows niggas can't fight.
I'm sorry?
You hate me, nigga. Niggas can't fight. They don't possess the strength for character or the mental quickness to be a great fighter. That's why all the best fighters in the world have always been white men. Jack Dempsey, Rocky Marciano, Sylvester Stallone, and don't forget Ralph Macchio. You name me one great black heavyweight fighter. Name one. Go ahead, fine, name one. See that you can't do it. What? Oh, you want to pull Ali out your ass? That what you think about? Muhammad Ali? Well, if that nigga so tough, then why he didn't go to Vietnam? I tell you why. Because he was scared. That's why. Shoot. No Vietnamese ever called me nigga. I called him a nigga 8 times before I had breakfast. Now what he gonna do? Hold on, I'll make it 9. Nigga!
I don't understand why I'm blindfolded.
Because the enemy cannot see.
But see, the thing is, I don't have super hearing, so I don't get why I'm...
Fight!
Ow! Stop!
Jean-Claude Van Damme's the best martial artist in the world. He killed a man with his butt cheek power. Steven Seagal, David Carradine, Chuck Norris, shoot. Walker, Texas Ranger. Now that's a karate man right there.
Word got out that my granddad was training for a rematch, and it quickly became the talk of the town. What was that? An exhibition? You need emotional content. Now, try again.
Damn, that hurts! Damn it, boy!
Ah. Ooh, everybody knows niggas climb trees, not kick 'em.
Riley had the brilliant idea to take Yvan's orders for the DVD release of the fight and take a little action on the side. He hired a street team to create the necessary hype. The fight had a huge turnout. Seems like watching niggas act stupid is becoming America's favorite pastime.
Hey, listen up! I'm gonna tell y'all one more time. This fight ain't starting till I get $10 from all y'all. Hey, you. Nah, nigga, I didn't get yours yet. Give me that.
That's the difference between private nigga moments and public nigga moments. A private nigga moment shames you. public nigga moment shames a whole race.
Oh, this is it. I'm gonna kick some ass now.
Granddad, the only way to win is not to fight.
That's right, Robert. Nobody's gonna call you a fruity boy or a pansy pants if you don't do this.
I will.
Right. Well, Riley will.
I mean, everybody's just talking so far. Go.
You scared? Yeah. You scared, ain't you, bitch, nigga? I can smell the bitch in you. Ooh, that vintage bitch. You must have Alzheimer's, old man. You already forgot that ass whooping? Uh-oh.
And as I watched Stink Beaner move blindly around the ring, I had a terrifying realization. He wasn't a trained swordsman, and he didn't have super hearing. He was a blind old man who had just gotten lucky.
Granddad! Wait! No! Stop!
Yeah, old boy.
Come on, Granddad!
You know, we could all be reading a book right now. And so, Granddad emerged from the nigger moment victorious.
Congratulations, Robert. I told you a nigger that black couldn't fight. Woo! Good going.
That wasn't even worth it, man. I've had my fingers crossed. You owe me money, man. Give me my money back. I want my money now. Give me my damn money.
Oh, my God.
I'm mad, man!
Niggas. As he contemplated spending the remainder of his natural life in prison, Granddad never stopped to realize that he had gotten the respect he so desperately wanted.
Yo, that mug killed a blind old man with his bare hands.
Now that's gangsta.
Robert Jebediah Freeman?
Tom and I had gotten the fight license by the State Boxing Commission at the last minute, legally indemnifying Granddad against Stink Meaner's death. But he was still pretty shook up by the whole thing. Colonel Stink Meaner had no family and no friends. He lived a life without love or companionship or even pets. He was a horrible, awful human being, and in truth, the world was better off with him dead. Still, he was our brother.
Forgive us for taking this man's life.
Why you say us? You killed him.
Shut your ass and pray, boy.
Sun in liquid form. The power pack taste of Sunny D.
Unleash the power of the sun!
Now enjoy Guinness anywhere.
Arctic Guinness draft in a bottle.
Marco!
So, I think we should get back together. Dumping you was a big mistake. A big, big... Oh, you're so freaking sexy. You have the roundest, sweetest, most incredible...
Rocco, why are you calling my daughter at this hour? Do you have any idea what time it is?
No. Do you?
Whatever you have to tell her can certainly wait until this weekend when she's down there visiting State U.
Mom, hang up the phone! Hang up! Rocco, are you high?
Depends on what you're wearing.
Stop calling me and leaving drunk messages on my machine, jackass! What?
Could you put your mom back on the phone? She sounded kind of sexy.
The best years of our lives aren't as easy as they seem. To get the girl and make the grade, it's all a show, it's all a game, and I would lose it if I played. But anyway, you go out.
Thanks for coming to the Safe Sex Floor Meeting. I'm super proud to see all my residents take this issue as seriously as I do.
Your flyer stated there would be chips and soda available. I highlighted the relevant sections.
Look, everyone! I made an ostrich!
Hey, Nitz. You accidentally dropped your safe sex pamphlet and free condoms in the trash.
Oh, did I? Thanks, Jesse.
God, Betsy! Would Jonah like me better if I wore thong underwear and put out? Ew!
Listen up, homies. The Duggler's gonna rap serious with you for a second. Date rape is no laughing matter.
Oh, Garfield! How are you ever gonna eat that much lasagna?
Peeps?
Oh, sorry.
Like I was saying, date rape, no laughing matter. To illustrate this point, here's a reenactment skit from Health Services. Peace out.
Oh my god. What's Rocco doing here?
Who are you talking to?
Well, here we are. Insert actress's name. Would you like to come up to my room?
I don't know. I don't really know you.
You know I got a futon and a boner. What more do you need?
Freeze. Now what's going on here? What should... Rocco! I said freeze!
But I haven't even copped a feel yet. What kind of crappy date rape is this?
That was such a joke. My mother talks about sex more maturely. And she uses words like pee-pee and bunny hole.
Nitz, what does promiscuous mean?
People who sleep with lots of people, Cal.
Ah, phew, guy. Good thing I never slept with any of my lady friends. We just played a little game I like to call unprotected sex.
And here's the star of our show now.
No, that stupid idiot fired me.
Why were you even in that skit in the first place? You don't go to our school.
My ex is coming to check out State U, so I need to find a girl to make her jealous. And I thought a date rape sketch thing would be a good way to meet chicks.
Rocco had a girlfriend? Was she mentally challenged or like a man or something? Okay, fine. For the sake of conversation, let's say your ex wasn't a total whack job. Why'd you break up?
It's sort of complicated. I know it's prom and all, but I'm breaking up with you so I can get laid by tons of chicks when I go to college. Oh yeah, happy birthday!
Hey guys, what are you talking about?
How Rocco dumped his ex.
Yeah, how dumb was that? He'll never get laid again in his life. Great news! I've created a program that allows me to hack into any PC and install a Gillian Anderson screensaver. Watch.
Sexy Miss Scully. I wonder if she ever had gonorrhea.
Real great, Gimpy.
Yeah, great if you're a freaking nerd.
Hey, peeps. Super screensaver. Listen, I've read all of the sex pamphlets thoroughly, so if you have any questions about what you've heard tonight, my door is always open.
I got a question. Why are you such a wad?
I do not see you. I do not hear you. I will not let you get in the Duggler's head with your bring down.
Yeah, right. Like I would ask the Duggler anything about sex? He's a total VID. Virgin in denial.
How do you know?
Come on. You can tell someone's a virgin just by looking at them.
Why aren't any of you looking at my Scully screensaver? Look at it! Look at it!
We've seen it, Gimpy.
But only with your eyes and not your heart.
So, you wanna have sex?
You tried that one yesterday, Einstein.
Oh, sorry. All chicks look alike to me.
Jesse doesn't know what she's talking about. You can't tell a person is a virgin just by looking at them. I mean, I don't look like a virgin. Do I? Cal?
Spreads quickly, leaving boils on the penis. Boy, I hope I don't...
Blah. Kimmy, what are you doing?
Hi, Nitz. Oh, I volunteer as a big sister to inner-city kids twice a week. Today we're finger painting.
My mommy shot my daddy because she loves me.
Mm-hmm.
I also volunteer at the Cancer Ward, Amnesty International, the Free Clinic, Greenpeace, the Free Tibet Organization, UNICEF.
She's done.
She's so pure and good. Don't you see? She's like the Virgin Kimmy.
Dudes, stop talking all this virgin crap and help me find a slut.
Ah, sorry, lady. No can do. What if you have something bad that burns?
Hello.
Ah.
Cal bad, me good. Sex, you wanna have?
Mm. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Ew,
oh,
I think he touched my arm.
Let me see if I understand. No one cares about my screensaver, yet you're all content to drone on for hours about this new obsession you have with sex. Girls are the enemy. End of story.
Well, not all girls.
All girls.
Even Rosie O'Donnell?
All girls.
Dude, what about Scully?
Agent Dana Scully is a woman of reason, science, and sharp Armani suits. She's a sterling example of American womanhood, untouchable by human hands.
Well, except for Mulder's.
The hell?
Yeah, dude. You know Mulder and Scully totally do the nasty.
Blasphemers! Mm-hmm. You will rue the day you besmirch the sanctity of Agent Scully.
Free condoms. What about free self-restraint? No one would have to wait in line to pick up some free morals, would they?
Talking loud is fun! Thanks for coming to the health center with me while I get tested, best buddy.
Yeah, well, anything to stop you from quoting STD pamphlets in your sleep.
As a general rule, we advise all patients not to have sex until your test results come back.
For a whole hour?
No, for a couple of days.
Ah, phew. You scared me for a second.
Sorry I'm late, but I've been running around all day and... This is totally boring, right? Anyway, I'll take 1,000 condoms, some lubricated, some unlubricated. Oh, and the red ones are great. Oh, hi, Nitz. How are you?
No. What an idiot. Kimmy's a virgin like me. How stupid.
Hey, guy. Oh, you're fast.
Yeah, not as fast as Kimmy. If she wants to behave like a indiscriminate, fine. But not me. I'm gonna show all the Kimmys of this world that I'm proud to be a virgin.
Yay, me too. I'm a virgin now too, guy.
Oh, now you want my help. The same man who hours ago defamed Scully the Pure.
Come on, Gimp. My ex is coming this weekend and I can't find a girl. You're smart. I need you to think of something.
Tell you what, I'll help you if you promise to take back what you said about Scully and allow me to broadcast your retraction over the net.
Fine, fine. Anything.
Please sign and initial this release form at the exit. We'll order you a bride online. You can use her to make your ex-girlfriend jealous, then simply return her to her war-torn Eastern European country within 7 days for a complete refund.
Hello, my name is Petrova Nablyovka. My father, mother, brother, and two sisters have all been killed in the fight for liberation. I enjoy cooking for soldiers, sewing up bullet wounds, and walks before curfew.
Dude, she's hot. I want her.
That'll be $16,000, plus shipping and handling.
Do they take Midas muffler points?
No, Visa and MasterCard only.
Damn.
Oh well, we tried. Now if you'll stand over there, I'll film your retract. You've forgotten one thing, my friend. I've got a legally binding signed contract here requiring you to perform the services as prompt. I need to have that bricked up.
Like a virgin, hey, touched for the very first time. Like a virgin, with your heartbeat.
Hi, thanks for coming to our campus support group for virgins. I'm Nitz Walsh, and this is Cal Evans.
Hi, Cal!
You're so fine, and you're mine. I'll be yours till the end of time, 'cause you made me feel. Yeah, you made me feel.
Come in.
Hi, Nitz. Got a minute?
Not really. I'm kind of busy.
I just wanted to talk about the health center the other day. I saw you run out and...
I was late for church, that's all. I was late for church and you were picking up a kilo of condoms. There's nothing more to talk about.
Nitz, I work part-time at the health center. Part of my job is to coordinate safe sex presentations with the dorm RAs and advise students on their sexual choices. That's what I was picking up the condoms for.
Blah.
When I saw you run out of the center, I got the feeling that you were embarrassed, and you totally shouldn't be.
Blah?
No. That's why I'm here, to set the record straight. Ooh. Because when two responsible, caring people make love, it can be one of the most totally amazing experiences ever. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Blah.
Look, I know this is a lot of information to process all at once, and that's okay.
Blah?
And don't feel badly. Most guys early on in their sexual lives don't even know how to properly put on a condom. Here, let me show you. Always start from the tip and gently massage the condom down.
Hey, buddy guy!
What happened? Where's Kimmy?
Yeah, she left. Nice ass.
Guys, I've got big news. Kimmy Burton came to my room and told me she wants to have sex with me.
Yay! Wait, I mean boo!
Yeah, I think you hit your head a little too hard.
It's true. She sat right here and showed me how to properly put on a condom. Where's the banana?
I ate it.
There was a condom on it. But it does seem a little weird, doesn't it? I mean, a few months ago, Kimmy didn't even know my name. Now she suddenly wants to have sex with me?
Because you were being extra virginal. It made her realize she loves you.
That is so stupid. You think a girl wants to sleep with him because he's acting all sensitive and hugging puppies and wanting to talk about feelings?
Oh my god! I love hugging puppies too! Hey, aren't you that creepy guy from those date rape skits?
Being extra virginal. Being extra virginal.
Shut up, Cal's voice in my head.
Okay, sorry, guy.
Hi, I'm Rocco, and sensitivity training is my life. Did I mention I'm a virgin?
Kimmy, hi, it's... Kimmy, hi, it's Nit. Kimmy, hi. Let's do it. Kimmy? Hey, it's Nitz.
I'm glad you called. I've been thinking about you. How you feeling?
Fine. Sorry for passing out the other day. I was just really tired.
Yeah, I know that feeling.
So I've been thinking about what you were saying, and I think I'm ready.
Great. Want to get together this weekend?
So soon?
I'm working at the health center, so why don't you just come by there?
The health center? Okay. I guess that's good. See you then. Holy crap.
So I told her it was the best apple brown Betty I ever tasted and gave her a daisy I grew in my garden.
Oh my god, Rocco, that is so sweet. I so admire a guy who's close to his mother.
And Kimmy wants to meet at the health center this weekend, so quick, Cal, tell me how to seduce a woman.
Sorry, guy, no can do. I'm a virgin now. I can't have sex until I get married, because I don't want to burn in hell.
Dude, whatever you do, just don't be yourself. It's totally working for me. Gotta pick up my bitch for another date.
Nitz, I'm sending you an audio file of a Chris Carter interview on NPR, where he explicitly denies any carnal relationship between Mulder and Scully.
Sorry, Gimp. Gotta go. I gotta go find out about life, about women, about what makes them tick. their likes and dislikes, and how to make sweet, sweet love to them all night long.
The hell?
Thank you, Garcia.
How to get a life, how to take a life. Ah, here it is. How to seduce a woman.
How to seduce a woman? No way, man. You and the skunk weed? This isn't how you do it, bro.
Well, then how am I supposed to learn?
Chocolate trouble, sweet lady cane, fists of dynamite, lips of love, Sir Pencilot, and my personal favorite, Black Jackson, mother...
Don't you have tapes to rewind, Whitey?
Look at those ancient cave drawings. It's amazing how man, even in its most primitive state, will strive to leave his indelible mark on the world.
And that hairy chick, she's really stacked.
I suppose so. In a very Earth Mother giving birth to the entire race sort of way. Wow, Rocco, you are so deep. Do you want to buy some vanilla fudge and read poetry to each other?
Only if I can braid your hair afterwards.
Betsy, it's finally happened. I have met the guy I always dreamed I would meet at college. He's so caring and sensitive.
Watch your ass, chocolate.
Ooh, what's the matter, Tyree? You not man enough to watch it for me? I got your number, Black Jackson.
Ding! Now serving 28, baby. And one size does fit all. I ain't never seen that slut in my life.
Well, maybe this'll refresh your memory, Sir Pimps-a-Lot.
Oh, yeah.
Man. That chocolate sauce is nothing but sweet-ass trouble.
Oh, yeah, yep. You can say that again.
Sure, brother. Uh-huh. You got that right.
I'm so glad you felt like sitting outside today, Rocco. It's such a beautiful day, and, well, I started thinking about us.
Uh-huh. Just, move right here.
These past few days have been wonderful. I feel so close to you. Even closer than I felt to Jonah the day he slapped me with that restraining order.
There she is. There's my ex.
She's pretty, guy.
Hal, get out of my head.
Rocco! It's not like you to be so aggressive.
I can't help myself anymore because you're so, hot. Our first kiss. Now, here. I'm ready, Charity.
Who is the man that'll seduce all the women with his seduction plan? Who is the cat that'll be having Miss Kimmy all up on his jimmy?
Nits!
Oh. I won't let you do it, best pal guy. I won't let you throw away your life for sex.
Move upside and let the man go through.
Okay. Watch out for DVDs, guy.
Hey, Nits, you made it. Things are crazy around here, so why don't we go somewhere with a little more privacy?
You've read my mind, baby. You have read my mind.
There's a 24-hour flu going around, and we've been swamped. What are you doing?
It's on repeat. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I wanna kiss you all over.
Nitz, are you feeling okay?
I don't feel half as good as you look.
Excuse me?
You heard me, woman. Don't try and fight this thing between us. You don't have to anymore. Kiss me, Kimmy Burton. Kiss me like I know you can.
Oh, Rocco. No, I can't. This is wrong.
Huh? What are you talking about?
You're so good and pure. It's wrong of me to force myself on you like this.
No, it isn't. Go ahead. Force.
Here you are, a sweet, innocent virgin, and I'm practically accosting you.
No, you're not. I'm not even a virgin.
What?
I just said that to get into your pants.
How could you? You pig!
Rocco, just as I expected. Oh. My. God.
I thought...
Nitz, that was totally perfect. You're, like, amazing.
I am?
I had no idea you were so good. I can't wait to tell the RA group we've got our new date rape actor. Thank you so much. Imagine that. Two people actually having sex in the health center. How silly.
Your test results are in, Mr. Evans. You're clean. 100% disease-free.
Whew. Thanks, nurse lady. Thanks a whole bunch.
All in all, I'm pretty happy with the way things turned out.
What are you talking about? You didn't get laid. You didn't even get close. You sucked almost as badly as I suck.
Yeah, but it's a step in the right direction. And a kiss on the cheek from Kimmy Burton is worth 1,000 nights in the sack with any other girl.
Even...
Yes, Cal. Even Rosie O'Donnell.
After days of researching, cross-referencing, being in the most hardcore of hardcore chat rooms, seeing things no man should ever see, I have proven that Mulder and Scully never slept together. Not before, not during, not after any of the X-Files episodes or movies.
Well, what about in that episode where Fox hooks up with Scully on that ocean liner in that alternate dimension?
Alternate dimensions don't count! All I have to say is, girl, you mean so much to me.
Stupid bloody bag, never get the bloody
thing. Hey, Dad?
No, I'm just cognizant.
But we really want to show you something.
I've got something to do, I'm trying to get this.
You really should see this.
What is it then? What is it?
These aren't Pepsis. They're Pepsi Twists.
You're a bunch of bloody magicians.
We're not the Osbournes.
You're not?
We're the Osmonds!
I'm a little bit country.
I'm a little bit rock and roll.
Yeah!
Sharon, the kids have turned into the Osmonds.
Oh, they're there, dear. Go back to sleep.
Like twists, Pepsi Twist and Diet Pepsi Twist. It's a twist on a great thing.
There's a better way to rent movies. As many as you want for just $20 a month and no late fees. Go to Netflix.com, make a list of the movies you want to see, and in about one business day, you'll get 3 DVDs. Keep them as long as you want without late fees. Then when you're done, look, prepaid envelopes. Return one, and they'll send you another movie from your list. It's easy.
Netflix. All the movies you want, $20 a month, and no late fees.
Poppables. Now famous candy bars are bite-sized.
Captain Jim J. James. Lieutenant Jen E. James. Robot. Kiko, the mute wild boy. And the rest of the Strata action team. Strata. Tonight's episode, Adventure 117, Beneath the Planet of the People.
Captain!
Take out that terry cloth and ever so delicately cover up my genitals.
I can't, sir. I'm just a geologist.
Oh, you're a strata geologist. Those aren't my genitals. They belong to Kiko. My genitals are over there. Thank you. Now, you must contact the Strata operators. This mission can't fail. The fate of the world is in your hands, Todd Rogers.
It's me, Malone. Saul Malone.
Then what are you doing with Todd Rogers' cold sore?
It's a mustache.
The coldest sore of all, Todd Rogers. The coldest sore of all.
I'm Saul. Saul Malone, geologist.
Meet Saul Malone. Some people are people, others, geologists. Tonight's episode, Prognosis, Earth Center.
My much maligned rock theory that I know in my heart of hearts to be sound and true. But I need to contact Strata first. Thank goodness we brought the antenna locator device. Who knows what happened? Dirty little methane-filled crack that mighty shaft may have fallen into.
Sister's retarded. Was she Chinese? Oh, that's right. She was stillborn.
Hedonistic, orgiastic, intercourse mongers. What carnal assault will they unleash on each other next? These cack-eyed capulators are drunk on fornication and cheap pineapple wine. Now's my chance. There's a whole village of them. An entire mongrel race. Hey.
Take it one day at a time with the Mole Men.
What's happening now? The Andy Griffith Show. It's Mole Men time.
Tonight's episode, Chapter One, A New Friend.
Hello.
From the very beginning, Smart Balance buttery spreads have contained no trans fatty acids and no hydrogenated oil. Trans fat can raise LDL bad cholesterol and lower HDL good cholesterol. Just the opposite of Smart Balance, which has the right balance of fats to help improve cholesterol. Smart Balance buttery spreads taste great without the cholesterol in butter or trans fat that's in margarine. It's that simple. Smart Balance buttery spreads. We have the right balance and the great taste.
At last they're here! New Butterfinger ice cream bars!
Hi, dudes.
Crispity, crunchity outside, creamy ice cream inside.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
Oh.
baton to dioxin. Knock, knock, who's there, Milk? It's me, I'm home. I bought lots of your favorite things at the store, Milk. You dumbass, will you sit down and shut up? The Four Tire Brothers is about to start. Here! I bought lots of your favorite things at the store, Milk! Oh, it's a special newscast, Tanagi!
Early this morning, a man dressed like a woman holed up in a publishing house, but he was presently arrested by police who arrived on the scene. In response to police investigations, the man claims that he only wanted to publish his full frontal photo collection.
I want to see it. Oh, it's probably the landlord. Anagi, turn the lights out.
Miss Milk! I know that you're in there! Come on!
Oh, he's got me.
You haven't paid rent in over 6 months! Miss Mill!
Yeah. So noisy.
Oh, Miss Mill, you will pay all your back rent today!
Oh, you're so noisy. I was sleeping. Can't we do this tomorrow?
Liar! I won't get tricked today, no matter what!
More importantly, Mr. Landlord, it's time for your favorite show, Montez Fighting and Splitting Couples.
What? Why, you're right. It's already started. Oh, my God, I was about to miss out on people's unhappiness.
Saved by the fact that that landlord likes to watch people's unhappiness more than his 3 daily meals.
I bought lots of your favorite things at the store, Milk.
Hey, Jetsco, I was just getting hungry.
Hold on a minute. Just wait. I've got plenty for you right here.
All right. Woof.
Okay, hold on a minute. First this. It's your absolute favorite. 500 times carbonated cola.
Yahoo! Milk loves carbonation.
And next, let's see. Here we have Kentucky's barrel of pork legs.
All right. Milk loves pork legs.
And look, 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 look here. A new discovery. Smelly Mucho from Koi Moya.
Koi Moya's new products are always so intense.
Shall we give it a try? Shall we try it?
Let's see.
Here we go! It stinks!
I was watching the sunset from a window at home. The twilight sky is so much like me. Day and night are mixed together, indecisive. I love him, I hate him. He's an angel! He's a scum-sucking, life-draining demon from hell. I'm so indecisive. Truly, I'm like twilight. I'm horny.
No.
Kill him!
Please, don't kill me. I beg you to reconsider. I'm not such a bad guy.
Hey, wait. I've got an idea. If you spare me, I will give all of you the Best Genist Award. How about it? Help me! Help me! I'm rolling down the hill! Stop! Stop! Adam, I can't catch up to myself. Movie, stop. Oh, wait, please, please, come on, hurry up. You gotta get your fat ass down here. Oi. I finally stopped. I'll be run over to death. Oh, me, hurry up. Me, come on, me. Come here, hurry up. Pick me up. Get me out of here. It won't stick. I can't. Come on, it won't stick. It won't stay. It won't stick. 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 Eh? A dream. Yes. But they put me to the guillotine. This country's people are unreliable. The nerve. I will exercise my military power. I'll fire the punishment missile at our country. The password is Breakfast at Tiffany's. Fire! It. Oh no! I fired our country's missile against our country! Our country's missile is gonna come down and hit our country! I fired our country's missile against our country!
Emergency! Emergency! Just now, it appears that someone has launched our country's missile against our own country.
This is a terrible situation. You there! Contact the president immediately!
Right! Roger, sir!
Ooh, it stinks! It stinks! Corn Maya's smelly mucho!
But the smelliness is what's so addictive!
Yeah, you're right!
Oh, I wonder who it is!
Yes!
Look, Milk! It's a package for you!
Oh, I bought that through mail order with my credit card! Tetsuko, hand it over!
What? You mean you bought things with the credit card again?
Shut up, you old bag.
But you didn't pay any of your credit cards last month or the month before.
You dumbass! Shut up! It's always money, 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 money! I'll pay it someday. It isn't something that gets used up.
But it does. By the way, what did you buy?
It's a Toka-chan.
What? Toka-chan? Let me see! But it won't hit me or anything, will it?
You dumbass. It's not just any Toka. It's a Tokoro. Die!
Milk, you bought such a stupid thing again.
Oh, telephone. Yes? This is Akane's lunchbox? Just kidding.
A missile is coming down on us!
Oh, Mr. President.
That's right. I am definitely the president.
Mr. President, did you try the smelling mucho from Koi Moya?
No, I'm afraid I didn't, but...
Oh, but you should definitely try it.
What? Is it that good?
No, it stinks.
It stinks. Forget about that, Milk-chan! It's just terrible!
But I didn't think you had tried the smelling mucho yet.
The president. So behind the times.
Milk-chan, it's...
Behind the times! Behind the times!
I'm trying to carry
the president! Behind the times!
Shut up! You're wrong! The president is not behind the times! I even collect Hawaiian jewelry for your information.
So uncool. Miss Pico, there's a Mr. Uncool here, too.
Mr. Uncool? How dare you call the president that? Outrageous! I'll send you to the...
guillotine.
The guillotine! The guillotine! My God, Milk, I forgot to tell you something very important.
Guillotine? I dare you to send me to a guillotine.
No. Never mind that.
Don't change the subject.
No! The president isn't changing the subject. Dr. Koba does not change the subject. Maggie Searad does not change the subject.
The president is getting more and more serious now.
Are you in love? You want to be, don't you? Well, this is the year of the rooster. And love that blossoms this year will be a love that will never lack for cock.
You can bet your money on that.
I mixed some cocoa. The melting whipped cream looked like you for a moment.
Whoa, look at the time. I'm late. I gotta fire my ass. Well, fuck 'em. I was destined to be more than a janitor anyway.
Hey, did you find him yet? Can't you get in contact with the president yet?
Colonel, the president's phone has been busy for all this time.
What?
That's right. The president absolutely loves Japanese stew.
Oh, Japanese stew, huh?
That's right, Milk. And now it's time to think. To think! What is the president's favorite thing in Japanese stew? Milk-chan? Yes!
Oh, anyway, did you watch Titanic?
Yes, I did. I did. I cried, I peed in my pants.
The huge ship sank.
It was so shocking. That scene shocks me no matter how many times I watch it.
Man, so long. I want to hang up already.
That's right. Speaking of shocking, traps are shocking.
Hey, Mr. President, didn't you have some very important business?
Important business? I just remembered what it is!
Hello, from the world of TV. I am the director of the King's Idea Laboratory, the pride of our nation. My name is Dr. Eyepatch.
Doctor! Doctor, how much more time do we have until our country's missile reaches our own country?
Before that, I would like you to watch this first. Promotional video. Start!
Our country's technology is the most advanced in the world. Our country's military might is unsurpassed in the world. Nito's footwear, Nito's footwear.
I salute our country's cutting-edge capabilities!
I salute our country's cutting-edge capabilities!
Our country's technology is the most advanced in the world. Our country's military might is unsurpassed in the world. The address is Nyan Nyan Nyan. The address is Nyan Nyan Nyan. Our country is very proud of our ultimate weapon, the punishment missile, and it can only be launched at the command of the president. When launched, the punishment missile flies into space, then takes accurate aim at the target to be punished.
Jibatron's house! No! Jibatron, run! Watch out!
Colonel! The president's phone is still busy!
A designer hairstylist. Yes, indeed, the president has his hair cut by a designer hairstylist.
The ones without licenses?
What does that mean? What do you mean by a designer hairstylist not being licensed?
I don't know.
A designer but without a license? No license but a designer? That's weird. Huh?
Yeah, that's beside the point. You're so behind the times talking about designer hairstylists, right? Tetsuko? Hanage? Mr. President's behind the times.
I am not behind the times. The president is where all the fashion begins.
No, you are behind the times. You will now be known as Mr. Behind.
Please stop it! The president is not Mr. Behind, I tell you!
G-Bot-chan!
In this way, it doles out punishment without ever missing its mark. Oh, the punishment missile is so splendid. Oh, the King's Idea Laboratory is so splendid.
Well, now can you see how splendid the punishment missile is that our country is so proud of?
Shut up! The president is not behind the times!
I am definitely...
Okay, and?
And I even buy all my clothes at designer boutiques.
What are you? An idiot?
An idiot? Milk-chan, I must say that's very rude of you. Take it back! I want you to take those words back. You refuse to? I don't care about myself, but I want you to apologize to that designer boutique.
Miss Pico! Mr. Uncool has made another appearance! Help me! He's going to kill me!
You said it! You said it again, Milk-chan! You quit making fun of your president already! I am a man who can even launch a missile with one push of a button. Missile!
Missile? I dare you to fire a missile at me.
No, Milk-chan.
Say what? Are you changing the subject again?
The president does not do things like change the subject. Dr. Koba does not change the subject. Nor does Akira Wakato. No! This is serious. A serious situation.
They said. What I want to know is, not about how splendid the punishment missile is. I want to know when and where the missile will strike, Doctor.
So I see.
Doctor, why are you silent? Doctor!
But isn't the home run battle between Sosa and McGuire amazing?
What are you talking about?
Colonel, you are very agitated. You see, you become easily agitated if you lack calcium.
I don't care about that! Where in the world is the missile's target?
According to the advanced computer of our country, the missile's target is... Apparently, no target has currently been selected.
What? Well then, what happens in that case?
Well then, the missile will pick a random target on its own.
What? Then we don't know where it's going to strike?
It sure seems that way. Of course, we'll know once it has struck.
And how much more time do we have until the missile strikes?
According to the advanced computer that our country is so proud of...
Yes?
Yes. To calculate the time of impact, we divide decreasing distance, input projected increased speed, and angle of present trajectory projections...
Seconds left! I'm finished! I'll get fired!
Civil service is tough. This was Dr. Eyepatch reporting from the King's Idea Laboratory that our country is so proud of. If you love someone, be brave and tell her. You'll feel relieved that way, regardless of the results.
Do? Doctor! Hey, doctor!
Hey, can't you get in contact with the president?
Sir, the president's phone is still busy!
Ah! I forgot something very important!
Well, so what is it?
Well, today's the official release date of the Ulfers' brand new album. That was close. I almost forgot about it.
Don't you have some more important business than that to talk to me about?
Yeah. I was sure I had some very important business to talk to you about at one time. I can't remember. I remember now.
He hung up. Talking on the phone so long made me hungry. Today's mission is complete now. Let's go eat sushi or something.
Yeah!
How do you describe a playmaker?
How do you describe a playmaker?
Guy who's clutch, who makes the big time plays.
In big games, baby.
He pulls guys.
Knocks guys. Rips guys out of their shoes.
Bang, bang.
Boom.
The playmaker makes the catch.
Over the middle.
He better not come across that middle.
Edge of your seat to your feet. He gets the stadium to go off.
Yeah, yeah.
And the guy that I'm talking about?
He's an offensive guy.
He's a defensive guy.
Hey, Ray, talk to me on Monday.
What'd you say, Michael?
Offense, baby.
Playmaker?
He's a tank.
Sports car.
A semi.
He rips it away when it matters.
Never, ever coughs it up.
He makes the big pass. He bats it away. He makes the big run.
Big catch.
The big hit.
He makes the big kick.
What?
Kickers will speak when spoken to.
Introducing Playmaker Control, only in Madden NFL 2004. The official game of Playmakers. Rated E for everyone. EA Sports. It's in the game.
Ms. Pac-Man's back, along with four other arcade classics, including Galaga, Pole Position, and more. Just plug it and play it. An entire arcade inside one joystick. Rated E for everyone. Batteries not included. TV games from Jack's Pacific. Products sold separately.
All right. No, no tea parties. No tea parties. Somebody's gonna get hurt. Come on. Grow up.
Einstein, Darwin, Edison, Alexander Graham Bell are all smarty pantses, but the chances they all burn in hell. Yes, they're the devil's clientele. So think with your heart, put a mortarboard on your aorta. Think with your heart and come graduate unto the Lord. Ask for anything lesser. Think only with your heart. He's our sweet savior, not a college professor. Think only with your heart.
God.
Go with the Lord. You know, Lily, Dale, and I thought it would be fitting to come out here to the Morrilton Zoo compound and sing our songs in front of God's creatures.
Oh, that's right, Leaf, honey.
Oh, honey.
Especially right here where the lamb and the lion lay down together.
Amen, Lily, honey. You see, this is our final farewell performance.
Oh, no!
Hear him out.
But don't worry. Leaf and I are going to be working on a solo project together.
Oh, honey.
Mm.
And I'm going to write a famous musical. A famous Broadway musical, huh? Yeah, thank you! Thank you! Thanks!
All right, class. It's time again to hold our annual elementary school juvenile pageant for children. This year, we have the honor of welcoming ex-Crucible Dale Armature, who will direct the world premiere of his never-before-wanted musical, Crooning Jesus.
Gosh, I just have to get that part. I was born to play Jesus.
Gee, Oral, who else would be even half as good as you?
Uh-huh. A plus, A plus, A plus, A, uh-oh, A. A plus. Huh? Junior, what's this? Crooning Jesus?
Oh, it's a flyer for the school pageant, Father.
But what's this, Michigas? Crooning? What's crooning?
It's like canting, but without the no Jesus.
I see. Junior, my son, when we finally realized the Messiah was right under our noses the whole time, there was one loss that was too heartbreaking to ever utter out loud. And that was the loss of all those canting lessons you took. When I think of how we flushed all my hard cash down the... Oh, yeah, sorry. when I think of how we flushed all your hard work down the crapper by accepting Christ as our Savior, holy oi! But now, Junior, I want you to get the lead role in this fakakta play, Crooning Jesus. You hear me?
Yes, Father.
Maybe we can get your famous Uncle Bernie to come see it. The man with plots like Joseph when Mary broke the news.
Blessed are those who hunger and thirst. They're what I call the opposite of worst. But most blessed are those of whom I'm most proud. The brave little guys with semi-eyebrows. That's my Sermon on the Mount. Thank
Thanks.
Hey, good job, Oral.
Gee, thank you, sir.
Come on, Oral, keep it moving.
Who's next?
Junior Christine.
Christine? Christine, Christine, Christine. Oh, like infamous Bernie Christine, Broadway musical producer?
That's my uncle. We see him every Christmas.
Christmas?
But if I get in the play, he'll make a special trip to come see me in it.
I see. Okay, let's see what you got, kid. Be good, 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 be good.
For my audition, I will be playing the role of Jesus, singing the song that ends Act One. I'm not a... him.
I'm not a Jew anymore. I've raised myself up off that dirty old floor. I've thought of a new Christian way to be.
God. I am a good writer!
Hello, crooning Jesus.
Haven't gotten the part yet, Mrs. Gray.
Oh, tut-tut, Oral. You're a natural.
Well, if it isn't the star of the singing song show.
Fingers crossed, Officer Papermouth.
Me too, Oral.
Break a leg, little Jesus.
Cast list should be up by now. Thanks, Doc.
Omelet face mask?
Yeah, you get it?
I think so.
Judas had
egg on his face. Yeah, I
do. It's sort of a switcheroo.
No, it isn't.
Sure, because you wouldn't expect him to have a whole omelet on
him. Reverend, I'm a writer. I know a switcheroo. That's not a switcheroo.
Then what is it?
I don't know. Nothing.
But it's funny. You can have it.
Fantastic. Thank you. Oral, come in. Congratulations, kid.
Judas?
Yes.
Not Jesus?
No, not quite. But between you and me, you got the better role. And he was Jesus' closest disciple.
Yeah, but...
I know. It's a big but.
Judas betrayed Jesus. I just can't, Mr. Armature.
Oral, he's a pivotal character. And there's a great song. Get a load of it.
I hate you, Jesus, you rotten little think. Your sermon never pleases and your parables all stink. Your eyes are beady, nose is weird, a goofy basket case. I'd like to take your stupid beard and rip it off your face. Prancing gaily on the water.
What?
I can't imagine ever singing that in a million years.
You're nuts. It's totally in your range of everything.
I had my heart set on Jesus.
We can't always get what we want, kid. And sometimes, we even never get what we want.
But who could play Jesus better than me?
Oy vey and hallelujah! I did it! I'm Jesus! I'm Jesus already!
So you see, Oral, that's the long and the short of it. I mean, I can't have two Jesuses. I mean, you think, what are you
doing? I'm sorry, Mr. Armature. I cannot play Judas.
Sure you can. Come on, Judas. Give it a try. Hit it!
I hate you, Jesus, you rotten little thing. Your sermon never pleases, and your parables...
Cut! Kid, you're killing me.
I just can't, Mr. Armature. I guess I'm not a good enough actor to really hate Jesus.
Okay, wait. Think, Kate. Think. Got it. You don't have to be a good actor, Oral. You can be a good Christian.
I can?
Sure. I mean, if you look at it in the grand scheme of things, it would never be Christianity if it wasn't for grumpy old Judas.
Oh.
In fact, you might even call Judas one of the bigger heroes of Christianity.
A hero?
You betcha. He was real important to the religion.
Then you know what, Mr. Armature?
What, Oral?
I think I can Judas Jesus!
Great news! Well, do you see him? Do you see your Uncle Famous?
Yes, there he is.
Get out of the way! Let me see. Oh, Lord. He's really here! Ah!
What's the matter, Mr. Armature?
They're here! Lily and Leaf!
The most popular two-thirds of the Crucifolk?
Yeah, them! Oral, this show has to be a hit. It has to!
Golly!
Golly's right! The stakes are high, pal. The stakes are...
I taught this mom with my sermon clutched in my hands. I need to...
I didn't expect that. Where's Oral?
And now I will tell you of my 40 days of fasting.
40 days of fasting! 40 days of fasting!
Make yourselves at home, this story has a way of lasting.
Holy cow, it's like a church out there!
Hey, what?
Hot dog!
I was kind of hungry, but I didn't get all that grub.
Hey, look, it's Oral!
There he is! Get him!
But why, Judas? Why?
Well, because... I hate you, Jesus, you rotten little fink. Your sermon never pleases and your parables all stink. Your eyes are beady, noses weird, a goofy masking case. I'd like to take your stupid beard and rip it off your face. Prancing gaily on the water, a long-haired, scrawny clod. You may be someone's daughter, but you sure ain't the son of Gaga, 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 God. I hate you, Jesus, with your boring miracles. Like 100 cheeses have been shoved right up my nose.
Judas! Judas! Judas!
I did it!
Hey, famous Bernie Christine, what do you think?
What do I think? I think if it wasn't for that pandering Judas song, this play would be totally forgettable.
Forgettable? My play is not forgettable!
Forgettable. I hate you, Jesus!
You rotten little fink.
Your sermon never pleases.
And your parables all stink.
Your eyes are beady noses weird, a goofy basket case.
I'd like to take your stupid beard and rip it off your face.
Prancing gaily on the water, a long-haired scrawny clod. You may be someone's daughter, but you sure ain't the son of God.
God, I hate you, Jesus, with your boring miracles. You smell like 100 cheeses have been shoved right up, shoved right up, shoved right up my nose.
Wow, everyone sure hates Jesus. Whoops.